guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is all about do-it-yourself artwork. How many times have you guys walked into Z Gallery or West Elm, even Home Goods, and thought, I love that art piece? And then you look at the price tag and you're like, holy moly, this is totally out of my budget. In this video, I'm gonna show you quick and simple ways to reuse those old art frames and make brand new artwork out of it. So for this first project, we'll be repurposing this old IKEA frame. You'll see that the painting inside is just too colorful for the aesthetic that I'm trying to go for. We're going for a really monochromatic luxe boho vibe. And I love that we're using this art paper that I found at my local art supply warehouse. I'll be lining that with leftover linen that I found laying around. And we'll also be reusing this linen for some of the other art pieces, so everything goes together. So the first thing you have to do is to remove the old painting from the existing frame. So the next step is to measure our linen and fit it squarely over the opening. The idea is to line our new art paper with the linen underneath so we have this really cool contrast. After you have your back panel cut out, you want to set that to the side since it will be the back of the panel. And then grab your art paper so that you can center this right over the opening at exactly where you want it. Typically, I'd be using spray adhesive to spray the art paper directly onto the backing. But seeing as how I am about to pop any day now, guys, spray adhesive is not the type of fumes that a pregnant woman should be inhaling. So we'll be using painter's tape to secure all the edges. You want to make sure that you pull your paper really tight and taut so that it has nowhere to go. So it's time to place on our back panel. Using the same methods as you did before, you want to even it out and flatten the panel so there's no folds or wrinkles. A trick to using painter's tape and fabric is that you want to tape the fabric piece first, pull it so that it's tight and taut, and then secure it to your backboard. Now it's time to put our backing back on. Masterpiece. Oh my gosh, I love it. A brand new boho art piece with no color in sight, and we reused our old IKEA frames and just a little bit of fabric. Love this. For this next art project, we'll be repurposing these metal frames using the same fabric backing liner and changing up the pattern of the art paper just so that we get a little variety. Since metal is a completely different medium, I'll have to use a spray adhesive to line the fabric backing directly onto the metal. So now that we have our first panel lined, it's time to place our art paper right over it. So you want to lay your paper out and place your frame right over it so you know where to cut. There's no need to make it perfect since our edges are imperfect anyways. I actually love that they're a little bit distressed. Our final step is to spray the back of this with spray adhesive, and then we just need to adhere right onto the panels. For our final project, we'll be repurposing this wood art piece. What I want to do is wrap the wood with canvas and paint my own piece of brushstroke artwork. I was inspired by some of the art pieces I saw at Z Gallery. I love how organic the art strokes are, and I think it'll look so beautiful with the bohemian vibe I'm after. I purchased this prime canvas from my local art supply warehouse. You'll need paint, a staple gun, a tray, and scissors to cut out the canvas. So the first thing you need to do is unroll your canvas, lay it right over your existing frame so you know how much to cut off. Make sure you saved any unused rolls for another art project. When you get to the edge, you want to make sure that you don't staple the ends so you have enough fabric to fold over and staple. So once you have your canvas all stapled, it's time for the fun part, painting. For brushstroke artwork like this, I like to use a polysynthetic paintbrush just so that it's easier to manage and you don't get all the little fibers on your canvas. I like to freehand the brushstrokes just so that it has more of a painterly quality. But if you're a little bit unsure about your artistic abilities, you can always use a pencil to mark it out and then paint right over it. And there you have it, guys. Not much to it, right? All it took was a little bit of creativity, some black paint, and there we have brand new artwork. Let's give this canvas a little bit of time to dry, and then we're ready to hang it up on our walls. For less than $30 and just a couple of hours, we repurposed 4 old art frames that I was growing sick and tired of. So instead of throwing it out, we just simply reused old fabric I had laying around, bought some brand new arts and crafts, and voila, brand new art pieces without breaking the bank. If you like this type of DIY videos, please give it a thumbs up. I love to scour my favorite shops like Z Gallery, Home Goods, Anthropologie, West Elm for inspiration. And then I find really quick and inexpensive ways to go home and do it myself. If there are any designer dupes you'd like to see in a future video, please let me know in the comment section below. Of course, subscribe to my design channel, and thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.